In November of 1990, a giant of the outsourcing market, DR Animation Studios, would first be established. Discovered by the Japanese animation studio Madhouse, established in 1972, this Korean company would enter into an exclusive partnership with their foreign forerunners nearly less than a year after their founding. By 2001, Madhouse would become partial owners and investors until 2007, when it would hold the rights as the majority shareholder. Because of this, many of the projects received by DR Movie would result from Japanese clients. The projects would employ the studio primarily as in-between animators, and at times call for some dipping into paint or inking departments. Currently, the company holds across its resume clients as Nickelodeon, Sunrise, the animation department of Warner Brothers, and Gonzo. The DR Movie Studio is the only Korean studio employed by Studio Ghibli. Evidence of producing work for each of these varied corporations still lingers within the history of this studio's productions. Gainax, on the other hand, first rooted itself to the industry under the name Daikon Film in the early 1980s. It would not become the company its fans recognize in present day until 1984. In its early days, the studio would work to produce in-house created stories, but since its second award-winning animation, it would begin to partner with outside creators, both direct-to-animation projects and comic-to-animated series projects. These outer sources would pave the way for the studio to improve upon its personal style and utilize this in future animated in-house endeavors. Created by a handful of university students, Gainax Studios would prove its adolescence in its first commissioned piece, Daikon 3. In this short, there's evidence of cyclical animation, a tool used for lower-budget animations and reducing cost. However, it would become a safety net for the Gainax team, as the studio would cling to this, even in modern day. On the topic of playing it safe, it is made evident by the heroine's design that the team sought to develop a simple character, keeping hair close to the head, clothes with minimal detail, and anatomy stylized. However, even in this form, anatomical errors are aptly noted. The crown jewel of the Gainax repertoire will perhaps always be the 1995 series Evangelion. This series would be one of two animated award winners for the studio, and would exist as the last in-house full creation for several years. However, the series would still be far from the company's current quality standard. Several, if not nearly all scenes in this cartoon, would force audiences to suffer too many seconds devoted to off-focused or distant camera shots. The scenes would linger in an uncomfortable angle, or resist movements at pivotal scenes, leaving many viewers with off-putting or mixed feelings. One of the many comic series animated by Gainax is the 1998 series entitled His and Her Circumstances. It further proves the inexperience of the studio in its early years, as many of the scenes feel very undeveloped. In fact, most scenes look incredibly similar, at times even exactly like, their comic page counterparts. Backgrounds are left undeveloped, many shots are left in black and white lines, and some cuts are done entirely as comic panels. Of course, leave it to Gainax to produce lemonade from life's lemons. The animators seem to have noticed their errors and reused this concept in 2000 while working on Foolikuli. This bizarre cartoon would pay homage to past studio works as well as to several established cartoons. The comic's look sneaking its way into animation was much more developed this time around and appeared far more intentional than in its predecessor. But this cartoon was not solely notable for its visual style. This series would prove to be Gainax's coming of age. Its animation would be filled with varied cartoon takes, experimental fast-paced camera shots, and anticipation. Gainax would build a legacy off the sheer amount of time it took for characters to perform in action, causing the inevitable result of the action's anticipation segment to feel more exciting than the oncoming action itself. By 2001, Gainax added a pinch of its magic into the first featured film for the series, Cowboy Bebop. This film, Knocking on Heaven's Door, credits Gainax as one of several animation sources. But because the studio's style is unmistakable, it is made clear where its influence lies. Interestingly enough, DR Movie helped to produce the very series Gainax was working for. The actual Bebop series had the studio working in its ink and paint department in 1998. Unlike Gainax, DR Movie did not hold as many years under its experience, having only a few works under its belt by that same year. One of these works the company was creating in-betweens for was Final Fantasy: The Legend of the Crystals in 1994. The animation reveals DR's own hiccups in anatomy, blatant cyclical animation, and inexperience in perspectives with dynamic camera pannings. Only a year later, DR would move on to producing in-between animations for feature films. The graphic novel, Ghost in the Shell, would be introduced to audiences worldwide on the big screen, first in 1995 and again in 2004. DR would assist in the production of both films and help establish a concrete style for the self-titled animated series that would follow shortly after. By the time this brand was introduced to IG Productions, the style set by DR would have forever cemented itself to its archetype. The mixture of human subtleties and movement, combined with radical changes in form, would remain constant for the characters of Ghost in the Shell. It was a successful mix that would continue on even in the series' second installment. On the rise, IG also found its way into Gainax's side of the world. From 1997 to 1999, together, the two produced three sequels from the original Evangelion. Proof of producing higher quality work upon a revisit, and heavily attributed to IG's own wealth of knowledge, Gainax was able to please its fanbase with a wonderfully redone classic, three times. This marked the very first time that IG would assist Gainax in their endeavors, the second time being evident in Fooly Cooly. For the span of 3 years, DR Movie would join fellow Korean outsourcing studios, JM Animation and Moy Animation, to work as a joint team of animators for Avatar: The Last Airbender. The creators Michael Dante DiMartino and Brian Konietzko expressed their desire for outsourced artists to gain a better grasp of the animations by leaving the bulk of the creativity to them. This produced fantastic strides of quality in each of the three companies and helped solidify the styles of each. Furthermore, because neither of the trio was issued solely specialized scenes, the studios began to learn from one another and take upon each other's knowledge. The animation work for Avatar ran from 2005 until 2008. However, DR took it upon themselves in 2006 to aid in the production of The Girl Who Leapt Through Time. This displayed a contrast in style from Gainax's work. It took the subtleties developed from Ghost in the Shell and reworked it into a new method of storytelling. As opposed to featuring the focus movement head-on or in the center of the camera, movements were very smooth and discreet, off on the side of scenes. Having produced works for Ghibli, the concept of showcasing minimal or forgettable motions to best encompass calm or progressing instances is made apparent in this film's animation style. By 2008, both studios released new projects. DR was, for the first time, able to claim a series entirely as its own, having been employed to produce not only in-between animation, but cleanup, key, and second key animation. Code Geass would serve as the brainchild for DR's future projects. It also marked one of the first times DR experimented with a style reminiscent of Gainax's over-the-top fighting sequences. Further honing its animated skills, Gainax launched Gurren Lagann in 2008. This series would feature the epitome of the Gainax style. If anticipations were radical in the past, these new animations were indescribable. Both of these studios shared similar struggles amidst their early years, but have since come far enough to enter their own glory days. While DR eases itself into fully animating future series, Gainax will pave the way towards the studios achieving in-house success. Together, these two are separate paths of the same forked road.